So today we are going to discuss about the another one problem, right? So that was the given data, the 200 kilowatts, 250 volt, 6 volt, then 1000 RPM DC generator. It's got the maximum gap density of 0.87 Wb per meter square. And here they are given, compared with the last problem, here they are given ratio of pole earth to pole pitch, it should be equal 0.67. And the ratio of pole core length to pole pitch, it should be 0.75. And efficiency of the machine, they are given 91%. Then the total number of ampere conductor used in the machine, that is the 31,000 ampere conductor per meter. This is the given data. From that they are asking you to find the diameter and length of the machine, right? That is the main dimension. While you are, you all know, while you are calculating the diameter and length of the machine, you should use the output equation of the DC machine, that is the PA, it should be equal to C naught into D square LN, that is the output equation. So from that we can calculate. Similarly, this is the output coefficient. This is, they are given in the problem itself, that is the generator. So the PA should be, that is the PA is the power developed in the armature, that is PA should be equal to P divided by the efficiency. And they are given separately, that is the, you see here the maximum gap density, that is the TG or BM value they are given. They are not given directly BAV, total or specific magnetic loading they are not given. BAV value is missing. That we can calculate by using this formula, that is the form factor KF, it should be equal BAV divided by PG, it should be equal P by tau equal 0.67, that value they are given. From that we can calculate BAV value, right? So BAV value we obtained. Then it is the generator, so power developed in the armature PA, it should be equal P divided by efficiency, the P value they are given. Then the efficiency they also they are given 91%. So from that we can calculate the PA value. Similarly, the output coefficient, we have the formula. Then BAV value already we obtained. Then AC they are given, that is the ampere conductor, they are given 31,000. So that all you substitute and find the output coefficient. So once if you are found out these two values, so that is the PA as well as C naught, you know, from that D square L you can obtain from this expression. D square L should be equal to BA divided by C naught into N, right? So you can substitute all the values and you can find the D square L value as usual. Then L by tau value they are given, that is the 0.75. From that we can calculate L in terms of D. Okay, the tau you know the formula, pi D by P, that is the pole pitch. So the L should be equal to 0.75 into pi D divided by, here the number of pole is 6, so you can put 6. Then L in terms of D we obtain. So you can substitute in the D square L equation, that is this equation. So you can substitute this value, you can find D cube. Then from that you can take cube root and you can find the diameter of the machine. Then the D value you can substitute in the previous expression. So you can find the L value, the D obtained T value. D value you can substitute in this equation, L in terms of D now. So the D value you can substitute here and you can find the L value. L it should be equal to 0.225 meter. Okay. So you can draw the diagram, that is the main dimension, diameter and length. Diameter we obtained and length also we obtained through this output equation. That is the main dimension of the machine. If the same thing, same type of problem, sometimes they may not give the values, right? So they will give initially the power rating, voltage and RPM. If they are given only these three reading, you can assume remaining all parameters. Normally the L B by tau or L by tau value, it is varies from 0.5 to 0.5 to 0.9. Similarly, the BAV value is varying from 0.5 to 0.9 and L by tau value is also varying from 0.5 to 0.9. Similarly, the ampere conductor also varying 15,000 ampere conductor to 30,000 ampere conductor. Okay, so if they are not given some of the data, if they are asking you to assume yourself, you can select most appropriate one, like between this range you can select. Similarly, the pole also from 4 to 8 you can select yourself. And if they are not given anything, only the voltage and the power rating and the speed, if they are given only three reading, the remaining thing you should select between this range and you can find the main dimension. Okay, this is the way to find the main dimension of the machine. Okay.